What's going on right now? Says Aragrutha. Here's the Ali. G'day, how are you? This is Ali speaking from Olidaytours. Today's live stream is to honor police officer Wilbert Mora, who was killed in the line of duty. We are sent here auf der Fifth Avenue und ihr habt hier einen Blick in den Süden in Richtung 42. Straße. Und da ist eine große amerikanische Fahne. Und hier auf der Straße stehen jetzt viele Polizisten, die dem ermordeten Polizisten Wilbert Mora ihren letzten Respekt zollen wollen. Wenn ihr mich gut hören und das Bild gut ist, sagt mir bitte kurz Bescheid. Es ist ein trauriger Tag in New York City, es war ein trauriger Tag, eine traurige Nacht in Deutschland vor 2 Tagen, als die beiden jungen Polizisten ums Leben kamen. Und es gibt hier so einen Spruch, der heißt, enough is enough.
The lineup will begin at 10:45. Please make your candidate seat until the search process is over.
Also wenn ihr mich gut sehen und hören könnt, dann bitte schreibt mir kurz eine WhatsApp durch. Wir sind hier auf der Fifth Avenue. Danke, Gerhard. Es ist ein zu schöner Morgen, um Abschied zu nehmen von einem Kollegen. Und wir sind live nicht nur auf Olidaytours, sondern auch bei Stadtführung New York, meine Stadt New York, dem New York City Livestream.
Okay, recruits, before the press, you are now on a 20-minute break. Be back at 9:20.
Um 9.40 Uhr geht es dann hier los. Und hier sind die ganzen Straßen großräumig abgesperrt. Ihr seht hier überall Polizeiautos. Kommen gerade die Polizeimotorräder reingefahren. Das sind alles junge Polizisten. New York City hat insgesamt ungefähr 35.000 Polizisten. Temperaturmäßig ist es heute angenehmer wie gestern. Gestern Abend hatten wir 0 Grad Fahrenheit bei uns draußen. Gute minus 10 Grad in New York City. Jetzt heute schmilzt der Schnee weg. Und ihr habt einen Blick hinter auf das Rockefeller Center. Thank you. tut mir einen Gefallen, bitte teilt den Film. Dann machen wir uns jetzt mal hoch auf der Fifth Avenue über die 46. Straße. Bis in Richtung St. Patrick's Cathedral. Sind sogar Polizisten aus Washington D.C. gekommen. Der Präsident Biden, der hat es nicht geschafft, nach New York City heute zu kommen, sondern der kommt erst morgen. Das wäre natürlich jetzt für so einen Anlass ganz passend gewesen, als Präsident, amerikanischer Präsident, hierher zu kommen. And if you're watching and you're speaking English, then please share the movie as well. Hier noch rüber auf die andere Seite. Das ist der Diamantendistrikt. No worries. Jetzt nochmal der Blick hier in die Fifth Avenue mit dem Empire State Building dahinter. Wenn man beim Polizisten vorbeigeht, sagt man, thanks for keeping us safe. Police organization providing peer assistance.
Task force that I've been on for years. The now president of the AMA is
Can I take one? Thank you, man.
I guess
you have a safe day.
I got anything. I don't give a fuck. I'm not saving my
life. Normalerweise sind meine Livestreams fröhliche, lustige, interessante Livestreams, die heute überschattet werden von dem Mord an die beiden Polizisten. Da zwei Polizeihunde. Man ist natürlich hier in New York City auf High Alert. Gerade an einem Tag wie heute. Und der Thomas sagt gerade, bei euch wird es nur runtergespielt. Schlimm.
Thank you.
So, ich glaube um 9.20 Uhr oder 9.40 Uhr, sorry, da werden sich die Polizisten in Stellung begeben. Noch hier steht ein Polizeiauto in der Mitte der Straße, um den Block abzuriegeln. Mit Polizeiautos hier in der ganzen Straße, direkt beim Rockefeller Center.
The mass will begin at $10. The lineup will begin at 10:45. Please remain near the canteens until instructed by the ceremonial unit.
Excuse me, sir. Do you know if they're walking up or are they walking down from
I'm
the
sorry?
Church? Are they walking down from the church or are they going to be walking up?
They're probably going to go down that way, but that's for the procession.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. Sorry
that's all right.
For losing a friend. Also es dauert noch ein bisschen. Hier habt ihr noch mal einen mega Blick auf das noch mit Schnee bedeckte New York City mit dem Rockefeller Center dahinter. So that's an amazing view of 30 Rockefeller Center. You can go up the top and enjoy top of the rock, and wherever you have a historic building, you got some information for it. Rockefeller Center. So, meine Hand schütze ich mir jetzt trotzdem an, denn es ist ein bisschen kalt. Ihr seid gerade live mit dabei. Ich muss gerade schauen, wo ich meine Handschuhe habe. Barrikaden auf Seite gemacht. sodass die Prozession hier stattfinden kann. So surely they've got to put the barricades to the side and then the procession is going to start. And we're also thinking of the two police officers that died over in Germany. They stopped the car and got gunned down. Very sad. Very sad. Die NYPD ist eine Familie. Genau, es geht um zwei Polizisten, die bei einem Einsatz in Harlem zu einem Vorfall im Haus gerufen wurden von einer Mutter. Als sie dort ankamen, hat der Sohn die Polizisten direkt erschossen. Ein weiterer Polizist hat dann den Attentäter ausgeschalten. Der Wilbert Mora, der ist nach ein paar Tagen im Krankenhaus gestorben. Und dementsprechend ist heute dann für ihn der Service. Excuse me, guys. You're from Lakewood? It's Lakewood, New York or New Jersey?
New Jersey.
New Jersey. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm from New Jersey as well.
Okay. Where?
Greenwood Lake, West Milford.
Oh, I don't know where that is.
Northern New Jersey.
Yeah.
And my brother is a police officer over in Germany, and two police officers got gunned down two nights ago in Germany as well, so I'm doing a little live stream to show what's going on. Thank you. You too. Also an der Stelle auch viele liebe Grüße an meinen Bruder, den Christian, der Polizist ist in Würzburg, und an alle anderen Polizisten, die vielleicht gerade zuschauen.
It's in a grass.
get the best shot to get the picture.
Hold on,
if you
guys,
take the picture from down here, you get the whole church. I'm a tour guide, so I take it. Ich weiß nicht, wo ihr gerade zuschaut. Seid ihr schon zu Hause? Habt ihr schon Feierabend? Steht hier immer noch mit seinem Schild. Die Polizisten sind nicht wirklich happy darüber, dass er hier steht. Wir haben ihn auch gebeten, er soll auf Seite gehen, aber der hält sich nicht dran, der sagt Freedom of Speech. Liebe Leute, wer sich eingeschaltet hat, wer sich jetzt wundert, was wir hier filmen. Vor gut eineinhalb Wochen sind zwei Polizisten bei einem Einsatz erschossen worden. Der zweite Polizist, der Wilbert Mora, der ist ein paar Tage später im Krankenhaus gestorben und dementsprechend findet heute sein Beerdigungsgottesdienst statt, hier direkt in St. Patrick's Cathedral. Mein Name ist Olli von Olidaytours. My name is Olli from Olidaytours. I'm a tour guide in New York City. I also do live streams. And look on my YouTube channel, you find a lot of nice, happy movies. Today it's not a happy day, it's a sad day. We're also thinking of the two police officers that died over in Germany, when they randomly stopped the car and got gunned down. So, da warten wir jetzt einfach mal ein bisschen, bis das hier startet. rockets have targeted this area. Also ein bisschen aufpassen, wenn man hier als Tourist durch die Stadt marschiert, vor allem zur Weihnachtszeit. Und ihr könnt auch ein kurzes Feedback reinschreiben, schreibt vielleicht rein, wo ihr gerade zuschaut, wie ihr die Situation in Deutschland seht. Ob ihr schon mal in New York City wart, könnt ihr gerne auch reinschreiben. Ob ihr bei eurem Besuch vielleicht sogar St. Patrick's Cathedral besucht habt. Das ist eine wunderschöne Kathedrale, 162 Jahre alt. Wer ein paar Fragen hat, kann das gerne reinschreiben. Ich bin gern bereit, euch ein paar Fragen zu beantworten. Servus Thomas, du bist gerade heimgekommen. Wir haben das natürlich früh angesetzt, mit dem Livestream, um euch zu zeigen, was hier an Respekt gezollt wird, was für ein Aufwand das ist, dass die ganzen Polizisten hier sein können. If you're not watching from Germany, Austria, Switzerland, maybe you can tell me where you're watching from. Dauert es noch, bis es hier weitergeht. 26th Avenue da drüben hat schon natürlich den Weihnachtsschmuck von der Fassade weggemacht. Da gab es diese ganz tolle Lichtershow zur Weihnachtszeit.
Anybody who's not a member of the service, just please walk down the block.
No worries. Thank you.
I'm sorry.
Okay. So, dann machen wir uns ein bisschen weiter nach unten. Das ist hier jetzt nur für Members of the Service, also nur für Polizisten. So, dann haben wir nochmal den Blick hier auf den Prometheus. Einfach einen Block weiter und respektieren die Vorgabe von den Polizisten. Wenn man kein Member of the Service ist, dann soll man zum nächsten Block gehen. Wir haben immer noch einen ganz interessanten Blick auf die Kirche St. Patrick's Cathedral. Und genug ist genug. Enough is enough.
Thank you.
weiter und dann schauen wir, dass wir da einen Platz finden. Habt ihr schon mal so viele Polizisten auf einmal gesehen? Wahrscheinlich nicht, oder? Und da seht ihr jetzt, wie viele Polizisten hier sind.
The mass will begin at 10:30 hours. The lineup will begin at 10:45. Please remain near the canteen until instructed by the ceremonial.
Servus Evelyn, grüß dich. Du warst auch schon in St. Patrick's Cathedral. Da hinten haben wir die Kathedrale. Troopers from Stafford Township in New Jersey. Schon gesagt, an der Stelle viele liebe Grüße an meinen Bruder, den Christian. Der ist Polizist in Würzburg, gerade Polizist in Deutschland, Österreich, der Schweiz, to all police officers in the whole wide world. You're doing a great job. We need you to do the right thing. And it's so sad if something like this happens. Seht, sind alles Polizisten. Ja. habt ihr ein Gebäude raus, Spitzen Park Avenue 432. Wie gesagt, das ist heute nicht wichtig. Mit Zoll und Respekt den Polizisten ums Leben kamen in the line of duty hier in New York City. Und natürlich auch den Polizisten ums Leben kamen in Deutschland. Ja, Thomas, und es werden immer mehr. Polizisten waren aus Portland, die da gerade vorbeigelaufen sind. Und hier in der Mitte habt ihr noch ein paar State Trooper. Nachher wird dann auch die Polizeistaffel hier auffahren. Trauriger Tag für New York City, ein trauriger Tag, eine traurige Nacht für Deutschland. Ihr könnt gerne ein paar Herzen durchschicken, das geht mir natürlich weiter direkt an die Polizisten hier. Hey brother, good. I'm doing a live stream to Germany. Hey, I'm known in New York City. You too. See ya. Wahnsinn, da ist gerade ein Nachbar vorbeigelaufen, ne, hier vorne. Also ihr seht, New York City ist ein Dorf und die Herzen gehen an die Polizisten, die zuschauen, an die Polizisten, die hier stehen. An die Polizisten, die gerade Streife fahren, egal wo sie sind. Ich danke euch. So, und da kommen wir jetzt dann in den Bereich, wo die ganze Straße gefüllt ist mit Polizisten. Für eure Liebe und Anteilnahme. Dann machen wir uns mal rüber auf die andere Seite, einen Blick auf die Betreiber.
You know what I mean? That it's gonna be like,
shut it to
so this guy is
könnt ihr Herzen schicken, bitte. Danke. Please send cards out to all the police officers.
So where can we go?
You know what? All those hearts go out to all the police officers.
I'm sorry?
All those hearts go out to police officers right
now.
Thank
you, yeah.
Thank you for your
great
service, man. Sorry what happened. I'm from Germany. We had two cops shot down two nights ago.
Yeah.
They did control a car. Like, they checked the car and they got shot. Really sad.
We had one last night.
Yeah, I heard.
Yeah,
but the guy is all right, right?
Yeah, he was on his way to work. It was sounds like an apparent carjacking.
It's crazy. Like, enough is enough, right?
Yep.
Thank you. So ihr habt es gerade gehört, letzte Nacht wurde auch wieder einer angeschossen, erschossen.
Thank you, be safe.
Thank you, you too. So zollt man Respekt. Schauen. Da habt ihr überall Polizisten, die stehen hier. Ihr seht's. Schickt bitte Herzen raus, Herzen an die Polizisten. Ich habe den Polizisten, mit dem ich gerade gesprochen habe, also gesagt, dass all die Herzen hier durchkommen. Eine Unterstützung für die Polizei ist. Das geht an die Polizisten hier in Amerika, das geht an die Polizisten in Deutschland, Österreich, der Schweiz, Europa, Amerika, die ganze Welt. Also tut mir einen Gefallen und schickt da einfach ein paar Fotos raus, ein paar Herzen raus. Kommt einem vor, als ob man hier alleine unter vielen Polizisten unterwegs ist. Und das hat nichts mit schaulustig zu tun, das hat damit zu tun, dass man Respekt zollt. Und ihr könnt eure Herzen bitte durchschicken, liebe Leute. Und wenn wir die Herzen kommen, halte ich wieder einen Polizisten an und zeige ihm, wie viele Herzen hier durchkommen.
Sweater.
Ohne Worte ist es, oder? It's without words. I said before, please send hearts to all the police officers. Click that heart button. Alle jungen Polizisten können sagen, dass wir sicher sein können hier in New York City. Unglaublich, oder? Schreibt gerne Kommentare rein. Would be great if you just comment a little bit of what you're seeing right now. Amazing. Ist der Wahnsinn, oder? Wenn ihr alle kurz ein Herz schickt, haben wir 80 Herzen, liebe Leute. Send a heart through, and if everyone who's watching sends a heart out to police officers, they do their job every single day. They get up and do their job. Die stehen auf jeden Morgen und wissen nicht am Abend, ob sie heimkommen. Selbst in Deutschland. Krasse Sache. Ich meine, ich war mit Tränen vor den Nachrichten gesessen, als ich das gehört habe. (lacht) 35.000 Polizisten hat die NYPD, aber heute habt ihr hier Polizisten aus vielen anderen Police Precincts. Polizisten aus New Jersey, Polizisten aus Washington D.C., die hier nach New York City auf die Fifth Avenue kommen, um den letzten Respekt zu zollen. Betty, thanks so much. And thanks for all the hearts that are coming up again. Thank you, guys. So habt ihr wahrscheinlich noch nie die Fifth Avenue gesehen, oder? So, jetzt müssen wir dann schauen, dass wir einen Platz finden. Polizisten, die begeben sich jetzt hier in Formation.
Hey,
Also hier nochmal der Blick in den Süden. Thanks, Bunny. Rest in peace. Officer Mora. Thank you so much. So, grüßt euch, hier bin ich, der Olli. Servus. Bin hier direkt auf der Fifth Avenue, mitten in New York City. Und zolle ebenfalls Respekt den Polizisten, die ums Leben kamen in Deutschland, sowie hier in New York City. My name is Olli. I'm here right on Fifth Avenue. In the middle of all those police officers that pay respect to their fallen brother and friend. So we're going to be live streaming today to show you what happens in New York City. I hope over in Germany they do the same thing. Ich hoffe in Deutschland, da wird es gleich gemacht. In diesem Sinne. Ihr seht, sind alles Polizisten. Wahnsinn. Der Service jetzt übertragen. Wenn ihr da auf YouTube geht, da könnt ihr den Film sicherlich auch sehen von dem Gottesdienst. Thank you. So an der Stelle nochmal, liebe Leute, schickt uns Herzen durch für die Polizisten, die ums Leben kamen, hier in Amerika sowie in Deutschland. Beim Carjacking wurde vergangene Nacht wieder ein Polizist angeschossen, hier in New York City. Dankeschön. Frauen durch, die haben Wasser dabei, die haben Kekse dabei, und den Polizisten, die hier stehen, was zu essen und zu trinken zu geben.
Yeah. In las aguas del bautismo, Wilbert murió con Cristo y con él resucitó a una nueva vida, que él participe ahora con Cristo de la gloria eterna.
Das könnt ihr wahrscheinlich auch hören.
Amen.
Amen. Es sind Tausende von Polizisten hier. Thousands of police officers are here. Victoria, gracias. Kommt einem vor, als ob New York City gerade stillsteht. Da drüben ist eine Frau, die hat ihre Fahne dabei. Back the blue.
Primera lectura. Capítulo 3, del 1 al 9. Las almas de los justos están en las manos de Dios y no los alcanzará ningún tormento. Los insensatos pensaban que los justos en la muerte, que su salida de este mundo era la desgracia y su salida de pronto una completa destrucción.
Let me know where you're watching from, guys. You must be wissen, wo ihr zuschaut. Seid ihr in Deutschland, Österreich, der Schweiz? Are you somewhere in America? Where are you watching from?
La inmortalidad. Después de ver el sufrimiento, sentirá una abundante recompensa. Pues Dios los puso a prueba y los halló dignos de sí. Los probó como oro en su historia y los aceptó como un holocausto. El día del juicio permanecerán a su lado, porque Dios ama a sus elegidos y cuida de ellos. Palabra de Dios.
In Deutschland, wenn zwei Polizisten ins Leben kamen. Es geht um die Welt, ich sag's euch.
Credentials?
No. Okay, no worries. Thank you, man. Can you just walk down there and get out? Okay, perfect. Thank you, man. Thank you.
Where are you walking from, man?
So if any one of you has a press pass for me, then maybe send me one. Wenn einer von euch einen Pressepass hat, dann hätte ich jetzt hier weiter marschieren können.
From the Holy Gospel according to John. When Jesus arrived in Bethany, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Now, Bethany was near Jerusalem, only about 2 miles away. Many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him. But Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been there, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you."
Josephine, muito obrigado.
"Your brother will rise." Martha said to him, "I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me,
que ninguna de nuestras palabras podrá ofrecerles una paz duradera. Como los amigos de Marta y María, nos dice San Juan, cuando murió su hermano Lázaro, muchos vinieron de cerca y lejos para consolarlo. momento están bordeando las carreteras, las autopistas, los túneles, los pasos elevados y los puentes hasta llegar a la tumba de Wilbert en Queens, esperando para consolarte, para caminar contigo y saludar a Wilbert por última vez. Esperan ofrecerte el único consuelo que conocen, mostrarte que las acciones hablan más que las palabras. Y detrás de todas y cada una de estas personas están sus familiares, amigos y compañeros de trabajo que exigen saber la respuesta a la pregunta: ¿por qué vas a Manhattan, de la ciudad de Nueva York?
Y la única respuesta es
y Él es el motivo por el cual nos hemos reunido esta mañana en esa misa, la oración más alta que conocemos para entrar en comunión con la vida, el sufrimiento, la muerte y la resurrección de Jesucristo. Es el poder de Cristo el que permitió a María, hermana de Marta, proclamar con fuerza y fe acerca de su hermano Lázaro: yo sé que resucitará en la resurrección del último día. Es el poder de sus palabras lo que hizo retroceder la piedra hasta el sepulcro en la mañana de Pascua. Es el poder detrás de sus palabras lo que permitió que 11 de los apóstoles soportaran la tortura y fueran sin miedo a su muerte. Acaso nos dice Jesús: yo soy la resurrección y la vida. El que cree en mí, aunque muera, vivirá. Y todo el que vive y cree en mí no morirá jamás. Son estas palabras las que prometen a todos los que nos siguen no una muerte eterna, sino la vida eterna. Son estas palabras las que inspiraron una frase popular que está en el corazón de cada oficial de policía de nuestro país y que levanta su mano derecha y jura defender a los miembros de su comunidad, conocidos y desconocidos, durante su turno y fuera de turno. Las mismas palabras que componen la frase de nuestro amado NYPD: Fidelis ad mortem, fiel hasta la muerte.
I walk in.
Durante esta vista y esta mañana, oramos por el oficial Wilbert Mora, como lo hacemos por el oficial Jason Rivera, que con esta misa, ya a través de la intercesión de San Miguel y Arcángel, y nuestra Santísima Madre María, que Dios los recibe rápidamente y con misericordia. Jesús.
again, whoever's watching, send us some hearts. Send some hearts out to the police officers that are standing right here to honor the life of Wilbert Mora. Wir Leute schickt uns ein paar Likes und ein paar Herzen für alle Polizisten, die hier stehen, die den letzten Respekt zollen. Und gedenken wir natürlich auch den zwei Polizisten, die in Deutschland ums Leben kamen. Schlimme Sache. Thank you for bringing the flag, my dear.
Overpasses and bridges all the way to Wilbert's tomb in Queens, just waiting to comfort you, to walk with you and to salute Wilbert one more time. They hope to offer you the only comfort they know, to show you that actions speak louder than words. And behind each and every one of those people are their family members, their friends, and co-workers, all demanding to know the answer to that question. Why are you going to New York City, to Manhattan? And the answer is because we must have
been. Thank you for the all the Herzen, liebe Leute.
Our words seem powerless.
Thank you for all the hearts coming in.
To work with and our family, but also to seek consolation. We seek to be consoled by the only one whose words have any real power, that he is the Logos, the Word of God. It is his words that begin to bring us beyond comfort to true hope. They are his words that begin to answer a hole that lies deep in our hearts. His words that begin to address the emptiness and the loss. To endure torture, to go fearlessly to their deaths. Does he not say, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die.
It is these words that promise all those who follow him, not eternal death, but eternal life.
It is these words, his words, inspire a popular motto that is at the heart of every police officer across our country, and who raises his or her right hand and swears an oath to defend the members of their community, those known and unknown, on duty and off duty, the very words that make up the motto of our beloved NYPD, Fidelis ad mortem, faithful until death. They are Christ's words that Wilbert first heard and learned as you raised him in the church from an early age, and that he received through you, his parents, godparents, and family. And I believe that
the fuck out.
No one can
do it
well that inspired me to love to family, friends, and people in the city. He promised to protect us with his life.
I asked for his permission,
offered to save more, even in his death. This morning, we pray for Officer Wilbert Mora, as we do for Jesus. We receive the support of the people who are living in this world. May God be merciful and quickly take them both to commit to us. Thank you.
ancestors of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant to them, and especially to Officer Jason Rivera, an everlasting home with your son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of the New York Police Department and their families, that the Lord may grant them fortitude, prudence, courage, strength, and serenity of heart as they fulfill their mission. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the safety and well-being of the people of the city of New York and all visitors to the Five Boroughs, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We seek the powerful intercession of our sorrowful mother Mary, the cross, and St. Michael, the angel. We make peace in all of our prayers in Christ our Lord.
We invite you to join in singing our offertory hymn, Shall We Gather at the River?
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Heavenly Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, in Him the hope of blessed resurrection is dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory is without end, we acclaim.
Thank you.
chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Recuerda tu hijo Wilbert, a quien llamaste de este mundo a tu presencia. Considere que así como ha cumplido ya la muerte de su hijo, falta también una gloria.
Church.
excuse me. Can you do me a favor and just hold this for a moment, my gimbal? Just hold it like this. Yeah. Because then I can put this away. Stop working. Thank you, man. So, liebe Leute, der Gottesdienst ist bald rum. Ich hoffe natürlich, dass meine Batterie ausreicht. Denn mein Gimbal hat den Geist schon aufgegeben. Wenn ihr genauso fasziniert seid wie ich von dieser letzten Ehre, die dem Wilbert Mora hier gewidmet wird, schickt mir bitte ein paar Herzen. Die Herzen gehen an alle Polizisten, in Amerika, in Deutschland, auf der ganzen Welt. Please do me a favor. Continue watching what's going on here in New York City right now. Send some hearts out to all the police officers. If you're watching, the ones that died in Germany, all police officers all over the world to do a great job every single day who get up so we can be safe. As we say, go and stop. When you see a police officer and say thanks for keeping us safe. Stopp und sag dem Polizisten mal, dass ihr stolz seid für seine Arbeit. Ich bin stolz, dass mein Bruder bei der Polizei ist. Und jeden Tag gehen sie raus und riskieren letztendlich ihr Leben. Wer hätte das gedacht, dass sowas in Deutschland passieren kann? Seid so lieb. Schickt Herzen raus an die Polizisten. Die alle im Spalier stehen, ihr seht's. Ich danke euch vielmals. Thank you. Thank you so much. Danke schön. Gracias. Für all die Herzen, die kommen. Wenn Polizisten zuschauen, wir danken euch. We thank you for your service. We thank you for keeping us safe. You put your life at risk every single day. Thank you for keeping us safe, guys. Be safe. Again for the heart. Thank you so much. You're the best, guys. Brother, thank you vielmals für all die Herzen.
Brother citizen, we reflect on his bravery. We remember his sacrifice. He's been our head since solemn prayer. Hear us, Lord. Protect us. Last night we were reminded again.
Letzte Nacht wurde man nochmal daran erinnert, dass es gefährlich ist, wenn Polizisten auf dem Weg zur Arbeit sind.
Realize that she did every tour with me, every night. tonight, every radio line, you wear the blue uniforms, but your families feel it every day. Just as officers, Mora and Rivera family, feel it today. It is why we are bound by our oath and our honor to stand together and salute his service as we commend his spirit. Let us pray for Officer Mora and for his family and friends. Their pain is our pain. Officer Mora was not only a dedicated public servant, but an exceptional young man, beloved by his family, the youngest of four children. Someone once stated to me that it is unnatural to lose a child. There's nothing in our English language that is associated with the loss of a child. If you lose a spouse, you're a widow, a widower. If you lose a parent, you're an orphan. But we do not have anything in our English language that defines the pain and the unnatural existence of losing a child. To his mother, Amelia, we pray for you. We lift you up in the support that you need. And to his dad, Badwin, we know how intense the pain will be and will intensify every holiday, every birthday, every sound of your son. I thank you for sharing your son with our city. And you must know, you share your grief and feel your sorrow. And to Wilbert's sister, Karina, and brothers Wilson and Jonathan, the challenges of losing a baby brother, we are your family now. We will comfort you and embrace you and stand with you in the difficult days to come. And to the 32nd precinct, his second family, I watched you at tonight at the hospital, saw how you embraced each other, and I heard you say over and over again, you try, you try. Yes, you do try every day and you succeed. You need each other more now than ever as you overcome this painful moment. Today we say goodbye to Wilbert, but we also thank him. The city thanks you. From the bottom of my heart, I thank you. And every day that I walk the streets of New York, the people of this city reminds me, support our police and let them know we appreciate them. New Yorkers understand the risk and sacrifice you make every day, and we applaud you for that. Our city is going to do more than thank you. We are going to give you the resources to fight this senseless violence. It is New Yorkers against the killers, and we will not lose. We'll protect our city. We'll work to end the gun violence that has engulfed our city with pain and despair, and protect those who put their lives on the line every day. People like Officer Mora and his partner, Officer James Rivera. Wilbert was only 7 years old when he came to our country, but he knew he wanted to be a member of the New York City Police Department right away. He was honored to serve and protect our city. He gave back to this country. He did it the way so many immigrants do every day, with hard work and commitment and dedication to be part of our American experience. He was proud to wear the blue uniform and serve the city of New York. He saved lives, but he did something else to really reflect on how special he was as an individual. After his transition from the physical to the spiritual, he donated his organs to five individuals who are now going to have life-saving abilities based on what he did.
Thank you.
And sister New Yorkers, this has been a lot painful last few weeks. But the pain unites us in this moment. In this moment of grief, we will rise to the moment and the purpose. But I know the powerful feeling that we have in this city. It will give us the strength to endure and move forward, to do everything we can to end the senseless killing and violence in our city, to build a city of peace out of the ashes of fear. We will rise, New York City, because we are a city of people like Officer Wilbert Rivera and Officer Mora. We will never forget their names and their acts of heroism. Officer Mora, our hearts are with you today and always. And we know your heart is with us. Before I take my seat, I want us also to reflect on Officer Summer. In that house, there were several rounds that was in that modified weapon. It's an AR-15 under the mattress. Officers responded to the 1015 call willing to walk through the door and face danger. Officer Summit did not take immediate action. We would have lost more civilians and potentially more officers. When I stopped to visit him in Queens with his family, we saw his commitment and dedication. I say to him, he's a hero to save the lives of his fellow officers. And I thank him.
Your Eminence, Cardinal Dolan, respected clergy, Mayor Adams, Governor Hochul, Los Padres de Police Officer Wilbert Mora, Gabina, Badui, Hermana Karina, your hermanos Wilson y Jonathan, extended family and friends, members of the 3-2 precinct, Officer Mora's Police Academy Company, 1865, police officers across our cities, communities, every New Yorker and person across this country mourning with us today. On behalf of the entire New York City Police Department, I extend to you nuestras más profundas condolencias. even among the city's skyscrapers, scaffolding, and buildings. At 6'3" tall, police officer Wilbert Mora was still a giant. His mother called him King Kong, and her strapping big boy. With his family at an early age, like the fabled character, he too found his way to the Empire State. And today we find ourselves here, where no one should ever be for the reasons that we are. An ocean of officers shouldn't have to line streets for the second time in 5 days to mourn the appalling loss of a 27-year-old son and brother. Gathered in and around a place that so grandly represents the enormity of faith. But the term faith is not just for the religious. It's weaved into everything we do. We just may call it something else. Police officer Wilbert Morris' family trusted that he, a beloved young man that had been sent off to serve this city, would return home to them. He always did. His colleagues in the 3-2 precinct had the expectation that he would work with them another day. He never failed to do so in the past. He absolutely loved this job. With a kind, gentle soul and an infectious laugh, he cared deeply about his family and truly valued his friends. An army of them stood vigil in the silent halls of Harlem Hospital, never once leaving his side. They hoped he'd come back, because he always wanted to give back. Born in the Dominican Republic, Wilbert and his family came to this country for an opportunity, safety, and security, and the better life that so many in this city work for and deserve every day. Attending John Jay College second on the course for public service, he then volunteered to make our city safe. He was convinced to do just that. Wilbert was the perfect candidate to join the NYPD. No one had to tell him to become a police officer. It was all he ever wanted to do. It was the most loved, significant, inextricable part of his life. I'm told the only close second was his PlayStation 5. But the threatening forces he faced on the screen were nothing like the malevolence that would take Wilbert Mora and Jason Rivera from our lives. With his combination of strength and compassion, Wilbert served this department bravely, honorably, as a colossal symbol of promise. Not for the size of his frame, but for the goodness in his heart. He was a true leader, a proud member of the NYPD Cadet Corps, an outstanding police recruit, an exceptional officer, and the first generation of his family to join a profession that asks courageous men and women to leave their own families every day to protect and help someone else's. Just as Wilbert and Jason did when they gave their lives in service of this city, they have my deepest respect and New York's immeasurable gratitude. And it is my honor and privilege today to promote William Mora to Detective First Grade. Even if you speak no Spanish, you understood every word that she said. inconsolable grief needs no translation. The NYPD is the most storied police department in the world. Our chapters chronicle when we are bowed, but even in deep mourning, we are never broken. This moment, this time, is in all hands. The story of the NYPD and this city is revered because when we are tested, we triumph. It's riveting because when we are battered, we get up. The incomprehensible tragedy of this loss, this execution, devastates a family, rocks the soul of a department, touches the heart of a nation, and tests the faith of this city. But the NYPD stands tall. We always do. With a few tens of thousands of our brothers and sisters, friends and communities, lending broad shoulders, standing side by side in support. Even through the tragedy of Detectives Mora and Rivera, the NYPD will always believe in New York City. And we know that no matter how you refer to faith, the Mora family can hold within themselves the wholehearted promise that the men and women of the NYPD, the daughters and sons of this city, will forever honor the sacrifice of their own. And we will humbly, unwaveringly, and faithfully carry on the towering and enduring legacy of Detective First Grade Wilbert Mora. Familia Mora, gracias por compartir a Wilbert con nosotros. Siempre estaremos a su lado. We are your family for life. Fidelis and Mora. Thank you.
Continued support and care are essential to our collective healing.
Wilbert Mora has given so much for our community. Let's make sure Wilbert's family knows that we, his extended family, love him dearly. I also call upon the public to do the same. Show our fallen brother and his family your support. They feel and appreciate your love and kind gestures, and will need it in abundance as they grieve his loss. Wilbert is just as much our son as he was Amadeus and Batu. As much a brother to us as he was to Wilson, Jonathan, and Karina. Let's not forget how important his contribution to our society is. Let's not forget his sacrifice. He was a son of our city, a new breed of officers, child of the change you asked for. He was the American dream. It was what you wanted and hoped for in your police force.
Wilbert.
His professional journey began as a police cadet in October 2018 in 25th Precinct. He quickly made an impression due to his stature and his temperament. He would never get angry or frustrated, and was so eager to learn, a trait that would remain throughout his career. He studied criminal justice at John Jay, but the likely topics discussed would prepare him for a career that would place him front and center with civil unrest, policy changes regarding restrictions, and increased constraints on law enforcement and bail reform. Like Jason, Wilbert would not be deterred from his calling. He remained steadfast and resilient as he completed the academy and came right back home to serve the Central Harlem community in November of 2019 with his assignment, 33rd Second Precinct. His fellow officers describe him as funny and outgoing, a gentle giant, being well over 6 feet tall and 6 feet tall and over 250 pounds. But it was said that when he walked, he never made a sound. If you were going through a hard time and needed a friend to lean on or a shoulder to cry on, no matter what time, day or night, Wilbert would be on FaceTime lending that support. And he was also very generous with his hugs. The leader that he is, Wilbert looked out for the new officers in the precinct. He took them under his wing and showed them the nuances of patrol. He was meticulous, looking over their paperwork to make sure every box was checked and all necessary questions asked and answered. His approach should be the model for those in the field training program. Wilbert would also organize group events to increase camaraderie amongst his co-workers, whether it was going out to eat or playing Call of Duty on his PlayStation late at night. I was told he wasn't very good at it, but it didn't stop him. Because it wasn't about winning, but of forging a family held together by a common thread, with a common purpose to serve and protect. While on patrol, he was all business. He took his responsibility to the public very seriously. He would respond to every job, and while assigned, he would take his time making sure all services were met and all parties satisfied before leaving. So as a cop, if you were on a hospitalized prisoner or a foot post and you needed food or a bathroom break, he wasn't the one to call. But that was because he was committed to an obligation to help the public and do so without delay. He would get to you, you wouldn't be forgotten. He would just mark that upon completion. In the field, his supervisors were all extremely confident in his ability to assess and make decisions. He was a guy to rely on to make the right call, no matter the nature of the job. This trait, especially with only 3 years on, showed a competency level generally attributed to cops much more senior than himself. He had his eyes on leadership and was studying for the sergeant's exam. His diligence and dedication to his work earned him the task of being designated as a steady sector Navy, toughest in the command. This rising star with a promising future was taken from us on January 21st, a day that changed our lives forever and punctuated the risks we face in even a seemingly routine job. On this dreadful day, Wilbert took the lead and did everything right as he, along with Detective Rivera, set out to answer the call for help. He asked all the right questions and gave instructions to the young.
limited space and cover, Wilbert used precious seconds while still in the line of fire to return fire. Being the born leader and protector that Wilbert was, he didn't freeze but fought back, trying to stop the threat and hopefully save others. To the Mora family, and especially his brother Wilson, know that Wilbert went out fighting. Although he's gone, you can be proud that, like you, he was a soldier and a warrior and tried to protect himself and his fellow brothers. On that dreadful day, Wilbert kept his promise to serve and protect, and did so until his last breath. As officers of the law, we must walk the fine line of having to keep our guard up and being on the ready, while still expected to treat situations with our guard down, both in visible appearance and even in action, often against better judgment. These three young men, two immigrants and one first-generation American, went into that situation with no intention of ever using their weapons. But the person they encountered had other designs in mind. We are thankful that Officer Sulan had the time, ability, and presence of mind to react in that instance. Officer Sulan, we thank you for your act of bravery.
Our next speaker will be the president of the PBA, Police Officer Patrick Lynch.
As we once again sit in this cathedral, and we pray for help to understand, and we pray to Jesus in a cathedral built by immigrants in the center of our city, the center of our church, and we ask for understanding to understand why can evil like this visit us? Why does sorrow like this come to our door? Why does a family have to face the sorrow that they do? And when we ask those questions, we can't help but think of the hero we are here to honor and will honor for all of our lives. And we look at the pictures that are in front of us, and the picture we have in our head, and the police officers that rode in those radio cars with our hero. The picture they see is a big, strong, courageous, handsome, a man with a smile that's firm, but full of love. A person that would go through a door knowing that they may not return. But I know as I sit here and look at this wonderful family and the sorrow in your heart and the tears in your eyes, I know when you think of your son, you don't think of a big strapping man. You think of your son, you think of a baby. You think of your baby, the baby you brought home. And as I can't help but think as a parent, if you're blessed to have a child, when you bring that child home, you look at that child, and they never grow up. And when you have that baby, you put your head on their chest, and you listen to their heartbeat. And you think of the life they're going to lead. As we were in that hospital and we were praying for a miracle, Cardinal, we were begging for a miracle. Please let this sorrow pass us by. Please let him be okay as we bowed our heads and prayed on the side of that hospital bed. I watched the parents, a father who tried to square his shoulder, a brother and sister who tried to do the best they can. I watched as a mother. Laid her head against the chest of her son to hear his heartbeat. A hero, yes. Your baby, first and foremost. I thought as you laid your head on your son's chest and you listened to that heartbeat and you prayed and you prayed and you prayed that this would pass you by and you get that miracle, I wondered, like, where does a person like this get the strength to put on that uniform, put that shield on their chest, to get behind the wheel of that radio car and answer that next call? And then I met you. Because when you raised your head and your family spoke, when you raised your head, you made a courageous decision. You made a decision to save others' lives. You made a decision to give the best. You made a decision to give the best of your son, the gold standard of life, the gold standard of his soul, his heart, his organs. So it doesn't make it easy for you. It's not going to make it easy for our police officers as they go into that muster room and they know there's an empty spot when his name is called. But realize the courageous decision that you made, that no one in this church would want to face and may not have the courage to do. Know that you have now given renewed life to five other people. Renewed life, yes, in our church. Renewed life that a human being can now walk down the street and there's a mother, and there's a wife, and there's a father who now are placing their head on their son and daughter's chest. Their son and daughter will be adults, but it's their babies. They will lay their head on their chest and they will listen to the heartbeat, because you saved their son, their daughter's life. They will hear the heartbeat of a hero in that heart. We hope those that get it stand up to what this man stood for. Use that heart. Use those organs. Do good in this world. Help us change the world like these two men wanted us to do. Your son is a true American hero. But more importantly than that, you are a true American hero family. And every police officer from around the world that packs this cathedral and lined that street and will leave our city and go to their towns will go with faith that if I can do half of what he did in his short life, we will have led a strong life. So as we tried to give our shoulder to you, it turns out you were giving strength to us. By you coming here and sitting in grief and making that decision gives every New York City police officer the courage they need to answer that next radio run, to go through that next door, to help that next citizen, and they'll do it in honor of a hero. God bless each and every one of you.
Our next speaker will be Wilbert's sister, Karina.
Es muy alto porcentaje. Por eso nunca olvidaré el día que mi hermanito se graduó de la academia. Wilbert, ese día se quedó plasmado por siempre en mi memoria y en mi corazón. Estaba tan profundamente orgullosa de ti, hermano, como lo estoy hoy. Cuando llegó la hora de entregar el diploma, dijeron Wilbert Mora. Yo sentí una paz infinita al saber que mi hermano menor no se perdió en las calles de New York. Estaba haciendo la diferencia entre los jóvenes de nuestra comunidad, en la ciudad a la cual eligió servir como oficial de policía. Jamás imaginé que mi paz duraría menos de 4 años. Desde aquel día, ese terrible viernes, llegué a casa. Mi papá me había hablado en diferentes ocasiones. Luego me llama y me dice, llegaron 2 policías a buscarlo. Le pregunté por qué. Me dijo, tenemos que ir al hospital. Sentí como si mi alma se congeló. Me sentí enloquecer, porque aún no decían nada. Mi corazón temía a lo que había pasado. Esa ha sido la peor llamada de mi vida. Desde ese día siento que estoy en una pesadilla que no termina. Me pregunto constantemente cómo y por qué llegamos aquí. La parte más desagradable de mi alma y de mi corazón es que después de hoy jamás te volveré a ver. Que tu alegría y tu sonrisa no llenarán nuestra casa. Nunca más escuchar decir mi nombre. Nunca más volverás a jugar conmigo lo pequeña que soy. Falta poco para despedirnos y aún no he encontrado la forma de decirte adiós, hermanito. No existen las palabras para expresar este dolor y este luto que nos invade por partida doble. Duele saber que 2 jóvenes ejemplares, como el oficial Jason Rivera y Wilbert Mora, nos fueron arrebatados al destiempo. 2 jóvenes que quisieron hacer la diferencia y un cambio en su ciudad con su servicio y su entrega. Ahora solo me pregunto, ¿cuántos Wilbert, cuántos Jason, cuántos oficiales más deberán perder su vida para que este sistema cambie? ¿Cuántas vidas más de los que nos protegen deberán ser arrebatadas por la violencia y el crimen? ¿Cuántas madres más, cuántos hijos tendrán que perder su familia por pasar por ese trauma y este tipo de tragedia? Los oficiales de la policía de New York nos protegen, pero el día de ellos, ¿quiénes nos protegen? ¿Quiénes miran por su vida? Eso no lo sé, pero lo que sí sé, y ustedes también, ¿quiénes son los responsables de evitar este tipo de tragedia que continúen pasando? Legisladores, el crimen terminó con la vida de 2 jóvenes ejemplares que solo dieron lo mejor de ellos a su ciudad. El crimen sepultó sus sueños y en sus manos están muchos otros sueños que no se han sepultado. Tomen acción, ya basta.
Thank you.
Can I invite Wilbert's cousin Clarabel to please come?
Estamos aquí reunidos para darle un hasta luego a nuestro querido e inolvidable Wilbert. Les agradecemos de todo corazón a todas las autoridades e instituciones que nos han brindado su apoyo en este momento tan doloroso para nosotros. Especialmente a la policía de Nueva York, el gran trabajo humano que nos han demostrado ante este trágico y desagradable acontecimiento, donde una de las columnas de nuestra familia fue desplomada, causando tan grande enorme vacío. Wilbert era un joven muy alegre que brindaba su luz donde quiera que llegaba. Que impactaba con su forma de ser, con su bella sonrisa y su humildad, inspirando a todos a mirar la vida con un sentido de optimismo. Era un ejemplo a seguir. Les confieso que asimilar esta cruel y triste realidad nos ha marcado causándonos un dolor irreparable que será muy triste y difícil de superar. A veces pienso que estoy viviendo una pesadilla de la cual quiero despertar. Cuando Wilbert nació, yo lo recibí en mis brazos y en ese momento sentí que era un pedacito de mi corazón y me cuesta creer que él ahora no está físicamente. Que no está físicamente con nosotros. Porque sí está en nuestros corazones. Desde pequeño le inculcamos valores como respeto, fe y el servicio a los demás. Y eso lo inspiró a ingresar al Departamento de la Policía de Nueva York, porque él siempre quería dar lo mejor de él y ser una voz para su comunidad, a pesar de los riesgos que se exponía. Él era nuestro orgullo. Hoy, con el corazón destrozado, recibimos sus restos para darle un último adiós después que un cobarde nos lo arrebatara, cuando él solamente cumplía con su deber y ayudar y poner el orden. Estamos muy orgullosos del sacrificio que él y su compañero Jason Rivera han hecho por esta ciudad. Les reiteramos las gracias por el apoyo que nos han brindado en este tiempo tan difícil. Y rogamos a Dios para que ningún otro policía pierda su vida en el desempeño de su trabajo. Hasta siempre, mi querido. Hasta siempre, mi querido bebé grande, Wilbert. Hoy ese cielo tan maravilloso tiene dos estrellas más que brillarán para siempre. Te amamos siempre, Wilbert. I love you. Gracias.
Before we go our separate ways, we take leave of our brother Wilbert. Might this farewell express our love for him, ease our sadness, and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ destroys his deathless self.
Please join in singing God Bless America.